The business community, led by the Director of Chamber of Commerce, Bosco Ogwang Edola, toured the project site before they converged at City Hall for a meeting with the stakeholders.
Division, yes, is the one which will be posted on the media.
Yeah.
Right.
I believe we are wrong for
Maurice Chris Ongom, the president of the City Development Forum, in his brief remarks, narrated their findings and warned the contractor against further delays.
The contract that we are managing is admeasured. If a road was you were told it is 20 meters and now it is 7, some people have the question, where did the money for the other meters go? The truth is that December is a business month. We will be doing business.
You people started grading this road. We were selling. Now, after you have come, you have put all the soil on our road, all that gap now we can't sell. Are you coming to destroy us?
Patrick Ogwang, the former president of the Municipal Development Forum, says over 100 agro-input dealers operating on Oro Road have been rendered out of business for the last 1 year.
Right now, it's not what we did in our design. You are cheating, Lango. I have to tell you that. Why? Just move to Oro Road, the box culvert crossing. Is that the standard of a box culvert? With the volume of the road flushing from Obote Avenue to that part of the road, will it handle? There will be floods, and I must say, I want to get ready for more floods.
I get for laboratory testing kit, which was supposed to be supplied at the beginning of the contract, so that it could help in the testing of the material. Yes. Up to now, we have not seen the laboratory test.
Lawrence Okelo, a petroleum dealer, urges the city leaders to take action before the problem goes out of hand.
Several towns have moved to Mbarara, have moved to Gulu, have moved to Arua. When you look at the quality of work which are done in those towns, we wanted our town also to sign, to grow like other cities. Our leaders, yes. You need to wake up.
James Mugisha, a city division councillor, explains that USMID aims to boost business, but the contractor is making it the opposite. He adds that when they complain, they are threatened instead of being helped.
They do saying that the project is from State House. The owner of the project is in the State House. Consultants, they are also compromised with these contractors. Because it is them who has failed to supervise the contractors. You are aware that this project came when we had left the lockdown corona. But Abubakar is more than corona.
Engineer Joseph Musoke, the contractor's representative, apologized to the business community for all the inconveniences caused.
To make an apology, especially to the mayor, for the seemingly empty promises we have been making over time. I also apologize to the business community, to the public in general, for the inconveniences that have been caused.
After listening to the remarks, the city engineer, Fred Owen, responded to the business community and told them their issues are being discussed with the ministry officials.
We had a space of 20 meters. Now, all the facilities that we are going to put on the road, including walkway, including traffic lights, including drainage channel, they will fit within the 20 meters.
Al Nawum Group and Abubakar Technical Services are carrying out works on the 0.18-kilometer Obankene Road, Notabel 0.251-kilometer, Abel 0.24, Orol 0.534, Uhuru 0.3 kilometers, and Boundary Road 2.177 kilometers. Story compiled by Hudson Apunyo for the news.